Becca, PRPC. So the application name, we call it as a PRPC, that is Becca Rules Process Commander. The full form for this is Becca Rules Process Commander. And popularly, we call this tool as the Becca tool or Becca application. So what actually we are going to, what are all the prerequisites that are required to learn this particular Becca tool or PRPC application? So it is built on Java-based application. Okay. So since it is built on Java application, and we require some kind of a object-oriented programming knowledge, but we don't require a kind of a coding knowledge. So we are not going to write any kind of coding here, but we should understood some part of the object-oriented programming. It's just like a conceptual. We do not worry about the programming and how the syntax looks like. So we don't need to worry about it. Since it is developed on Java-based application, so we just understand about the object-oriented programming. That's good enough to start the PRPC application. So that is up to what level of knowledge that we should have. So if you have the basic knowledge, then that is fine. So you don't require the master or advanced or something. So if you have the basic knowledge about this object-oriented programming, that is enough to start. And here, we are not going to learn the entire, we are not going to understand the, or you don't require to go through the fully object-oriented programming. So if you have the classes concept, that's enough to learn this. So if you have the knowledge on the classes, that's enough to. So as part of this session, we are going to cover this, the basic knowledge, whatever is required to PRPC, we'll be covering in first couple of classes. And then we are going to enter into the original PRPC application development. So why we are actually using this PRPC application is, so we are going to develop the application. So we are going to develop the applications using this particular PRPC application. So what kind of applications we are going to develop is, it's a web-based applications that we are going to develop. And which domains that we are going to use this particular PRPC? Popularly, this particular application you can use in the banking domain, insurance domain, and healthcare. Okay, and we are going to use in the HR care services, and we are going to use in financial services. We are going to use in the government services and energy services, right? So there are so many domains that we can implement our PRPC applications. So again, within these domains, what kind of applications that we are going to build using PRPC? See, we are going to build the process-oriented application. So wherever you want to automate the process, okay, wherever you want to automate the process, there actually we are going to implement our PRPC application. So what actually we are going to automate in case of the banking and insurance? Let's say, for example, the bank organization, day to day, they might be getting lots of requests in terms of personal loan, in terms of mortgage loan, in terms of credit card, in terms of frauds. So there are so many requests which are actually coming to the organization. That means the day-to-day business data which is actually coming into the banking organization. So they cannot actually manually follow, or they cannot manually do the things for the customer, right? So what they are going to do now is they are actually automating their system. Okay, they are automating their system so that the system is going to take care of the lot of responsibilities. Let's say we are going to achieve the 70% of the automation by using this PRPC application. Okay, so to automate that. That's why we are saying that PEDA is one of the BPM implementations. That is business process management. So whatever that day-to-day business data which is coming in, to process that business data, we are going to use this PRPC application. That's why it is a BPM implementations. So the techniques we are going to use, that we will learn how you are going to automate the business data. Okay, and your, how your machine is going to process that one. And in the insurance also, we are going to have a lot of, we generally have the claims, insurance claim. So when you are going for the hospitalization, right? So we just apply for the claim, and the organization is going to process your claim, and a lot of approvals is going to take in care automatically, right? So there also we are going to use this PRPC application. So like healthcare, HR sales services is another example, like onboarding applications, starting from recruitment and till the employee is going to onboard, right, within the organization. Till that, there are lots of process will be there. So to automate that process, I think we can use this PRPC application, right? In financial services, so here again, we are one organization is going to have a lot of goals. They set some financial goals for this year. So to process that, when you are onboarding the project and till delivering the project, there are a lot of things are there. So to automate that particular process, again, we can use our PRPC application. So like in the government services, we are going to use energy services, we are going to use our PRPC application. And pharma, another example, so we are going to use that. Okay, so customer service, again, we are going to use this. So there are lots of domains that we can actually use our PRPC application to automate their business data. So when this tool has introduced, so this is not the very new application. So it has a it was developed during the 1980s. Okay, it's not very new to it. So they have a lot of versions meantime. So the versions are like 3, 4, 5, 6, and recently we are working with 7 versions. Okay, so these versions, up to these versions, so we required some kind of Java knowledge. Okay, not some kind of, we required actually the Java knowledge. So now these versions are nobody is using. So the versions which are using now is 6 and 7. So 6 is the major version which has a lot of improvements, and you can develop the application without writing any piece of code, without any customization code, that you can develop the application. But earlier we required the strong knowledge in the Java, because we used to write a lot of customization code to automate the application. So now it has reduced a lot, and in 7 we completely going to develop the application without writing any kind of code here. Okay, and the differences, like why I'm giving you the difference, major difference between the prior to 6 and the 7 versions is like they have done a lot of improvements here. Is so earlier they are using actually the UI development HTML. So you don't really do the HTML design here. We are going to actually drag and drop the controls on the form. So the behind the controls which are generating is the HTML. And 7, they are actually using the UI development, that is HTML5. Again, you don't need to learn the HTML5 or HTML to design the page or something. We are simply using the drag and drop facility. So not thought out the pipe. So why they have changed this is, previously, if you want to develop an application, okay, if you want to open the application in different devices, right? If I want to open my application in tab or mobile or any other device, HTML is not responsive. We know that, right? Responsive is like you are going to design once and you can access that particular application or content in any device. So the content which is actually fit to exactly to the particular device. So using HTML, we don't get that one, but we can still develop it. But you cannot actually make it responsive. Okay, you cannot actually make it responsive. If you want to still do that, if a customer asks the application I want to open in my mobile, so you have to have the separate environment for that. Again, if you want to open in the tab, so you again require the another environment. So customer has to maintain the different environments for different devices if at all they want to open the application. So HTML5 is the responsive. So you are going to design once and you can access in any device. Okay, that's the beauty of the HTML5. That's what we call that HTML5, responsive. Nowadays, everybody is trying to open all the applications or right anything within the mobile or tab or anywhere. Automatically, the content which is fit to the device itself. That's what the major changes that has happened in the 7 version. Apart from that, there are a lot of things are happened technically. So those things we are going to see later on. And here, how the application, I mean, how the organizations are going to be sell these applications, how they are going to actually develop it, what is actually the business model. Here, each and every organization is going to have the data application, right? And each organization, like let's say that CTS or TechM, okay, Infi, SCL, each and everybody is going to develop their own frameworks. Okay, each and everyone is going to develop their frameworks. So if the customer asks any application that they need, directly what the organization is going to do, so these organizations are going to directly sell those frameworks. So the customer or the end user, they can directly customize that particular framework the way they need. Like you are going to shape the clay, right? So the way they want, so we can actually very easily we can customize that application. Okay, we can build the application on top of this framework. So there are a lot of companies are going to develop their own frameworks, like the insurance frameworks, a lot of frameworks are there, banking, there are a lot of frameworks, onboarding, there are a lot of frameworks. So you don't have to actually really develop the application from the scratch. There are lots of resources which are already available in the ERPC system. We are going to develop again the applications by using those resources. Okay, so here the development of the application using ERPC, it is 4 times faster than any other applications. Okay, we can actually develop the application 4 times faster. It is not only the application you can develop very fast, we can actually improve the process compared to the previous versions, which is up to 45%. Okay, we can improve the process is up to the 45%. Let's say customer was using any other application previously. If they switch to the Pega, so they can resolve the things that is up to 45%. They can increase the response. So here, if you are resolving, if you are automating the process, right, that means you are satisfying the customer. So in the business model, the customer satisfaction is very important. So you are going to achieve that using this particular application. That's why many of the organizations are going to be the ERPC, because you don't have to really develop the application from the scratch. Again, we are going to improve the process greatly. Okay, we are going to improve the process greatly. That's why the ERPC has become popular now. So we have actually different competitors, okay, like any other programming. So Pega also, they have their own competitors. So we are saying that the BPM tool, right? So there are a lot of tools out there. One is the Pega, right? And we have IBM is there. and we have Oracle is there. Okay, we have APM is there, we have JVPN is there. So there are a lot of VPN tools available in the market. So why the what is the importance of the data? So due to other tools, I mean, if you are going to, you can also develop the automated application using these tools. But here we require a lot of customization. We cannot achieve the automation fully. Okay, and we have to do a lot of customization here. So whereas if you go with the Pega, so they have improved a lot. So we don't have to really develop the application from the scratch, and you don't have to do the customization code here. Okay, and this is having a lot of advantages. So that's why Pega is always the BPM tools. Pega is always be the first position compared to other BPM tools. So that's why the Pega is very popular nowadays. And here, like any other applications, you can work with integrations. Okay, you can work with you can connect to any database. The security is inbuilt. Like any other tools, you don't require the, really the separate administrator to manage your applications. Okay, we really don't require the separate administrator. So here the developer can act as a administrator. It is not like really the top tool. Okay, the tool is configured like very user friendly. Anybody can understand the features which are available in this application. So here, what if the so we have actually different types of roles that are there. So the roles are like CSA, CSSA, LSA1, LSA2, like that. And there are separate roles which are related to the business side also. Okay, the business user, they have different roles. So we don't need to worry about those roles. We have a lot of roles out there. Business analyst roles also is there. So we don't need to worry about those roles now. So as a developer, so CSA is like a developer, okay, software engineer. CSSA is like a senior developer, and LSA is like an architect who is actually going to design your applications. So we will be always involving either CSA or CSSA as a developer. LSA, like these people are going to be designing the RDC applications. They are actually designing the architecture of the application. Okay, so again here, if you are holding the different certifications, so we are actually going to have a different package level also, not like other certifications. I mean, the technology we used to do a lot of certifications, right? So maybe we don't have the importance of using those certifications. So Pega is certification very valuable. As long as you are holding different certifications, so your package and your roles and responsibilities are completely different. Okay, that's how it is. And here, this particular application is PRPC is very lightweight, right? So this particular training is going to cover both the CSA and CSSA. So here, if you come to the environment for this application, so this is very lightweight only. So you don't really require the heavy configuration of your machine. So it's very lightweight. If you have the Windows 7, minimum Windows 7 and up to 10, so it is going to work. If you have the 4GB RAM, that's fine. Okay, if you have the 15GB space in any one of the drive, right, so that's fine to install the PRPC. We don't really require the heavy configuration to install this particular software. And PRPC is going to provide you the two types of software. One is personal and another one is the enterprise software. So personal is actually that for learning purpose, you can install this particular software. And enterprise, the organizations are going to purchase the license. So the personal here, it includes the Pega files, And since it is the web-based applications, we are going to use the web server is the Tomcat, and the DB is the PostgreSQL. And we are going to get the JDK since we have to install in Java-based application. So here, these are also common. The enterprise customer can choose their own web server like WebSphere or WebLogic or whatever it is. And database also, the database server they can use like SQL, Oracle, okay, MySQL or DB2 or whatever the customer is using. And JDK is again common because the Java applications, when you want to run, so you should have the JDK to be installed on your machine. So the personal we are going to get as a package. So you can easily install, that's an easy procedure to install this particular software. At enterprise, we just required a little configuration to configure your own web server and the database. It's very simple. We'll be working with personal edition, and don't mind that you are going to miss anything. So the options which are available for the personal and enterprise is common. Okay, so personal and enterprise application is going to be the common. So you don't see any differences between the personal and enterprise. Okay, except the choice here. That's it. So any questions so far?
The enterprise version, which contains app server, or it's also web server?
Sorry?
The enterprise version of Pega, which contains any app server or only web server? They're using only web server.
No, app server, both are there.
Okay. So
what? Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, what app server they're using?
Where?
The enterprise version.
App server in the sense, maybe I'm not able to.
Yeah, application server, right? Normally, you see, the web server is different from application server. So just I'm asking that, like, see, WebSphere, those things are all app servers, right? So Tomcat is a.
It depends on the customer actually.
Okay.
If they already having the WebSphere, right? So why they want to have another web server or app server? So okay. They can easily going to be deploy on the app server only.
Okay.
So I don't know actually if it's a web server or an app server. So you just clarify. So share is an app server.
Okay.
So it's like the development of the PRPC is really, you don't require any technical stuff here. Okay, we actually need the how you can actually implement the requirements. That level of knowledge that you have, so it is good to go with the PRPC application. We don't really require the developer knowledge, or only those people can survive. There are a lot of non-technical guys are also there within the PRPC development. Yes, just go ahead, Rajiv. Yes, Rajiv, what's your question? No, I'm not able to hear you. You can type here. You can type your question, Rajiv. It is pre-built with data layer also. That's what. So you don't have to additionally do anything or any configuration when you are building your application. You can develop the framework. That's what I'm saying. It's not, Pega itself is not a framework. Pega is an application development tool, right? You can develop the framework for an application or whatever it is. So organizations, they are going to develop, not Pega is going to develop the frameworks, right? Because in this competition, we do not want to wait the customer like for 6 months or 1 year to release the application they can use, right? So now it comes with ready made. So today you give the framework and tomorrow you can develop that particular, you can do the customization on that and you can give it to the customer, right? It comes with the data model. It's a fully automated system. So, any other questions?
Yes, Naresh, this is Rikin. Yeah, so would you share contents, like what will you explain during this course, or what topics will be covered and all?
Yes, Ashok will be sharing with you the content, so you can go through the content.
Okay, and so would that, during this course, would that help, like how much helpful it will be to pass CSSA certification?
CSSA, alone, if you want to write that particular CSSA application, we will require some hands-on. Not just once you complete the course and write the exam, is not suggested. CSA, you can finish it. Okay? So CSSA, it requires some kind of a hands-on. At least for 6 months, it is required.
Okay, and would you cover topics on integration services like SOAP service, REST API?
Right. We are actually going to cover the SOAP, the request, and I mean we have a connector and a service. I mean we are going to consume the service. We are going to do all the service, and also we are going to work with the REST.
Okay.
And we'll be doing the email integrations also.
Okay, that's good. Thank you.
The total duration of this particular training is 35 sessions, okay? And each session will be the practical only, okay? Every class will be the practical. And we have the daily classroom notes, okay? That which we are going to provide you with that.
Do you have any tutorial or any kind of we will do some hands-on work also exercise, or just follow your lessons, your sessions?
I have a couple of exercises that I'm going to share with the students.
Okay. So you will help us in installing. We can install this application in our laptops, right? I mean, we can install this and download and install it.
Yes, it's a simple installation only. You just follow the navigation. That's it. Next. So it doesn't require any modifications like configuration file, nothing else. You just go the simple navigation. That's it. Next.
So are there any prerequisites in terms of Java that we need, Java JDK that we need to install, or any specific version, because I do have Java, a couple of versions of Java installed in my laptop.
So the PRPC package, I said, right? So it's a package. You are going to get everything, with respect to the versions only. So you don't need to worry about it.
Okay.
So from when the new batch is starting?
Probably, I mean, actually, I plan for tomorrow, so Monday will be starting India time.
From
will
Monday?
It be the same time? Will it be at this time only or some other time?
No, yeah, Naresh. Naresh, we will start on our Tuesday morning, 7 a.m. IST. That is their Monday, our Tuesday morning, 7.
Okay.
Guys, the class on your Monday, guys. In India, it's Monday is a festival. Something naughty is going on. So we will meet on your Sunday. On your Monday evening.
Okay, so 5 days or 7 days?
It's 6 days, sir. Actually, Sunday we don't have classes. In your timings, it's a Sunday to Friday. Saturday we don't have class. We follow India timings Monday to Saturday.
Monday to Saturday. Okay.
That's for US guys. It is Sunday evening to Friday evening.
Okay.
Yeah. And Ashok, can you share the contents, like
sure,
the
sure.
topics?
I will, for everyone, I will email.
Okay.
Thank you, guys. If any questions, you can post to Naresh. If not, then we will wrap up for today.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, Ashok. Thanks. I'll give a call.
Okay. Okay. Okay, Raja. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Raja.
Thanks, Ashok.
Bye.
Thanks, Naresh.